recent developments with the TPP?
Yeah, thanks, Richard. We talk a lot about Operation Sovereign Borders in Australia, but the real threat to our sovereignty that the government doesn't want you to know about is secret trade deals that are occurring in Sydney this weekend. 12 countries are coming together at the behest of big, powerful corporations, like big, powerful pharmaceutical companies, to put at risk the laws and regulations in our country that govern significant areas of public interest, such as Australians' rights to cheap and affordable and accessible pharmaceutical medicines. I'm going to hand over very shortly to the NTEU, who's going to talk about their concerns about education and the Trans-Pacific Partnership Agreement. But let's say this is the biggest trade deal in this country's history. But trade ain't what it used to be. This is not about selling cows or putting cars on boats or iron ore. This is about corporations pushing to synchronise laws between countries. And as legislators, it's very important that we get to see the text of these secret negotiations. Now, the Senate has compelled the government to release the text of these negotiations, but the government has refused, saying it's not in the national interest for them to release the details of this deal till it's done. But once it's done, it'll be too late for Australians and their representatives in Parliament to change anything about this trade deal. But the decisions being made in secret are absolutely critical to this country's future and to our communities. Now, access to cheap and affordable medicines, we know, are at risk. It was revealed in Senate estimates last night that the government is using them as a bargaining chip in their negotiations to help get agricultural access through this deal. It's simply not good enough. We need to see the text, and all Australians and all stakeholders need to have input into what is 29 chapters in this deal that covers just about every aspect of life in this country that's about to be traded away by people we don't know at the behest of big, powerful corporations. I'd like to hand over to the NTEU, and following that I'd like Senator Di Natale to make some specific comments about the risks to our pharmaceutical benefit scheme and access to cheap and affordable medicine. Oh, sorry, Adam.
Thanks very much. We have a number of concerns about the Trans-Pacific Partnership. They range from the breaching of Australian sovereignty, and given the Abbott government's complete willingness to sacrifice the public interest in favour of fossil fuel companies and the big mining corporations, we've seen that comprehensively since it's come to power, we have no faith that it would ever put the Australian national interest above corporations' interests, and that seems to be what they're doing with the negotiation of the partnership agreement, where they are simply not opening it up to the public. We're very concerned that the agreement also has no enforceable labour rights. That's an issue not only for Australia, but for the other countries where Australian companies may in fact go and use the agreement to enforce lax labour standards in other poorer countries. We're very concerned in our sector that it would open up higher education to any company that wanted to come in and set up some sort of higher education facility in Australia and just be given government funding to do so, and undermine our 150 years of public investment in universities in Australia. We're very concerned about some aspects of what the TPP might do for teaching, for instance, in the health area, where there is a proposal that, believe it or not, medical procedures could be patented, and so certain operations, certain forms of operation might be subject to patent. And we can't see how what the effect that's likely to have on university health and medical schools is likely to be very negative as well. So we have a large number of concerns about this agreement. We want it to be opened up and exposed, and we certainly don't want the right of foreign corporations to sue the Australian government, which is what the TPP and the government is negotiating at the moment, surrendering our sovereignty without any fight. Thank you.
I'll just say one or two very quick things about what the TPP means for the healthcare of ordinary Australian people. Put simply, it's a risk to the price of medicines. Consumers are going to potentially pay a lot more for their medicines, and there'll be fewer of them. It's a risk to our medicines industry because it does a couple of things. Medicines potentially will become more expensive and we'll have fewer of them because under this trade deal, there is the potential for corporations to challenge our pharmaceutical benefits scheme because they see that as a threat to competition. If we end up with a situation where one of the best systems for funding medicines anywhere in the world, that is the Australian pharmaceutical benefits scheme, comes under threat, what are we giving away in order to sign this trade deal? We're giving away people's access to cheap medicines. It makes no sense. There'll also potentially be fewer medicines because one of the other things that's currently being negotiated are deals around patents and restricting access to data transfer between those companies that do the research and development on medicines. So if we end up with the situation where patents are extended, preventing the entry of cheaper generic drugs, if we end up with a situation where this new class of drugs, called these biological drugs, that are now the future of medicines, where entry to new players is prohibited because they're able to retain the data around the research that they do without sharing that, as is currently the case with existing medicines within a particular time frame, well, we won't get an industry in this country where people can access a broad range of these new potentially life-saving drugs. So it's a big threat. As Peter said, we're engaged in a race to the bottom. We've got corporations gathering around the world engaged in a race to the bottom to see whether we can bring the standard of legislation down to the lowest common denominator. And the threat to Australians is access to cheap and affordable medicines, and the Greens won't stand for it.
Thanks, Richard.